80. We're doing it. We're doing it. It's happening. The finals. It's going to be Deer versus Bunny. And spawning. Up on the top left. He's been playing quite well this tournament. 3-0-ing his opponents. Playing for Kaizy Gaming. It is Bunny. And his opponents. Also, 3-0-ing his opponents. Both of them happening to be Zerg players. The player playing for Team Newbie, it is Deer. So we got a best of 7 to finish it all off. First map, once again, being Triton. Seems like these players like playing on Triton. For whatever reason. Geez, stop the camera thing! Oh, my eyes! Oh, I'm getting nauseous! Mom, get the trash bin! Deer's like 45. What the fuck? What is a scout? Ooh, is he going to do a proxy? Are we proxying? Ooh. Proxy Stargate? Let me see, dear. What you got? What you got in store? Give me some non-standard PVT here. Let me see what you got. Throw it at me. So I'm actually just sitting here very relieved, to be honest with you, that we have a Protoss in the finals. So that way I don't sound like a complete fucking dingus whenever I'm trying to analyze a non-Protoss matchup, so this is honestly fine. I'm quite content. We also are getting a new champion this time. Were any of the other? Wait a minute. Who won the third one? No, it was Cure twice and Solar once. So actually, yeah, we from the beginning, from the first stage, we were gonna have, this actually might be a proxy Twilight. Even no, it's gonna be Stargate. Uh huh. Should have stuck with my second gut. Boop. Yeah, once Cured got knocked down the first round, we were immediately going to have a new champion, because Solar was the only other one that's won one of these. Cure won twice. But we may have our first Protoss winner with this one. Proxy Blink DT. Oh, dude, he's gonna get scouted. Oh, right as he drops the Dark Shrine as well. Get absolutely fucked, dear. Holy moly. Adept's coming and shading into the natural, but there's nothing here to kill anyway. Doesn't matter. That scout is massive. Gonna just switch it up into Blink. Just gonna be like, oh, nope. Nothing to see here. I'm just proxying my totally normal Stargate, or my totally normal Twilight tech choice opener. I'm just going for a Blink opener. Nothing to see here. Please continue on with your Reaper Scout. Bunny will be doing the Widowmine drop. Seems like he's been favoring this versus Protoss today. He did it. Two games versus Trap. I can't remember what the third game was. Okay, wait. What? No, it was only two games because it was a 2-0. Right. There was no third game. So he did two Widowmine drops. This is now the third Widowmine drop out of 3 PVTs he's played. Reaper will get chased down. I don't think it's going to die, though. Nope. Widowmine's going to come boosting on into the natural. But there's plenty of stalkers here, so not going to do anything. Actually, he's just going to lose the medevac, even. Yeah, that did absolutely nothing. Two probes, see you later. Awkward. So Marine's like, huh, I'm pretty sure there's something over here. Oh shit, there we go. Ooh, okay, so Deer is going for the fast 3 base blink charge double forward style. So this is the style that's supposed to be not as strong anymore. Due to the charge nerf or whatever. So I'm curious to see how this is going to go. You can still make it work, you can still do it for sure. But I've just been seeing a lot of Colossus styles recently instead out of a lot of the Protoss players in this matchup. So I'm very, very curious to see how this one will play out for Deer. Especially considering he did get his initial build scouted out. Didn't really put him that far behind, it was really just a cancel. The wasted resources on the Dark Shrine. So in terms of how the build is actually lining up, he's not actually behind really in that regard. Especially with the Widowmine drop being defended as cleanly as it was. Blink is finished now, so he'll be able to go and blink into the main if he so desires, but that would be an absolute suicidal move, so he decides not to. Wonderful. Now if he did, it'd be actually pretty decent, but he doesn't really have enough stalkers to really threaten anything. He'd be able to kill a tech lab in like 5 volleys or something like that. Instead, just gonna poke away at some of the units. Bunny nicely micros the units back up into the medevac. Charge will be finishing up just in time for the push. And Deer will continue to blink away. Some shield batteries getting put in down, Immortals getting cranked out. The full 8 gateways are now about on call. Oh. Tried to make the third CC on location, so a bit greedy in that regard. Gets it cancelled by the stalkers still stalking around. And now the big load up. Will he see it? Observer not quite there. Gets a nice, perfect field goal. 3 points for Bunny. Right in between the army vision. Gets into the main base. And we'll see how much this can do. Deer does still react quite quickly. He's going to get up here nicely. The Widow Mines could potentially do a lot, but get targeted on one of the Warping In Zealots. Another one Zealot there. Oh, then warps onto the Widow Mines. That was interesting. But it does deflect it quite easily, despite the fact that he went right through the vision. So nicely done on his part. Looks like a couple units were reinforcing, also get kind of killed off there. However, he will be able to kill the Twilight Council, so that's actually kind of annoying. Luckily, Deer quickly started 2-2 just before that Twilight was picked off. If he had missed that, that would have been a real big killer. But Bunny now is going to push up the aggression, going into his classic PvT style that he always tries to do, attacking as much as possible, getting a whole bunch of drops all over the field. Deer does have a pretty decent vision coverage. Oh, that's unfortunate. That's very unfortunate. But a very good pick for Bunny. That's going to relieve a lot of pressure. Whenever you're going for these two base styles like this, heavy two base before with a delayed third, it's always super vulnerable to go for so many different drops at the same time. If you're putting so much of your army on the other side of the map, you're really exposing yourself to a big counter warp in. Like, you can see how little is actually here to defend anything. If a warp prism comes in right as this army is reaching your side of the map, one big warp in can do a critical blow to the economy. So that's a very big pickoff for Bunny. He doesn't have to think about that in the slightest, so he is fully prepared to bring every single unit he has all the way across the map. Oh, that Zealot is so unlucky as well. God, Deer's getting a couple of unlucky hits on these scouts. Is not going to see this third, or this four medevac drop actually coming into the main, but he has quite a lot of units prepared. Bunny easily reacts to it though. Nicely done. Nice Zealot warp in, or his run by, going all the way around to the third base. Bunny's not paying attention, so he loses all his medevacs. Rip. Ooh, actually, the sentry's getting picked off by the Widow Mines is quite bad. Another force going into the third base. Drags that mine onto all of the Zealots, but will defend. Finally picks off all those Zealots. I actually did a pretty decent amount of damage. Anybody know where Parting was commentating? Yeah, he was commentating the BJ Destruction Team League, which amazingly wasn't even announced. Like, that's that tournament's the reason why I had to change the time of this tournament to later than usual. And, like, it literally just wasn't even announced. There was usually there's a thread or something, there's some sort of announcement about it, but there's, like, actually nothing. It wasn't even on Liquipedia or anything. Just hilarious. But yeah, he was commentating that. Denies the fourth base, Deer does. Nicely done. Bunny scanning to see if there is a fourth base of Deer's own, but it is actually up here. Kind of an interesting spot. He took this fourth base versus Ragnarok as well, last series. Kind of an interesting choice to take this one instead of this one over here. I'm not really sure what I think about it. You can see Bunny's even getting duped by it too. He's like, okay, where's your fourth base, dude? I scan down here, I got a Marine over here. Are you just sitting on three bases right now? Am I getting all in? But no, he's actually just got it right here, and now finally a Marine will be able to see it, and he'll know exactly what's going down. Warp Prism will be able to send out some Zealots. All the upgrades, Warp Prism Speed, 3-3, Dark Shrine, initially was cancelled, now being made again in the main. Oh, I love the Disruptor Switch. I love it. This is what I do. This is what I do in PBT. Thank you, Ganoi, for the 200 bits. Much appreciated, mate. Hope you're enjoying the tournament. But yeah, I really love going into Disruptors because so many players are relying on Ghosts to do a lot of damage with EMP being so strong as it is now. Disruptors are such a nice way to mess with that, especially because Vikings are the other natural counter. You're gonna need Vikings to deal with the Colossus. So if you go Colossus first and then force the Vikings, and then they're making Ghosts to supplement their army regardless, you're then making a unit that is not dealt with by any of those two units actually. Nice Zealot run by timing here, gonna be able to kill off a lot of the SCVs before this planetary is set up. Gets a lot of them actually. Oh, there's another Zealot warping in the main, so he warped some in, dropped some over to the fourth base, and then we did another warping up here. Very nicely done. Kills off 21 SCVs with a very simple move right there. Gonna try to push into the main, or the third base now. With the Zealot warping going into the natural once more. Deer looking to be in quite good control here. The Disruptor Shot's gonna get thrown out. Nice reaction timing, does not get... Okay, that one was a bit risky. Vikings are going to be able to clean up all the Colossi, but again, that's a lot of Disruptors, and you can see the power that they have clearing up a ton of the ground units. With no Warp Prism to reinforce, though, this is making it quite awkward. There's a drop at the fourth base, too, killing off a lot of drones, or probes, I should say. But this drop is still going on into the natural of Bunny, so he is still losing a lot of SCVs, too. Actually kills the fourth base, wow. That's actually really nice. Oh! 5 points. 5 hit points. Kills off the Warp Prism. This planetary is still not set up yet, so if Deer actually jumps on this right now, he can kill it, and that would put him in a huge spot. Nice, does so. And he'll be able to zone out with the Disruptors as well. Nice kill on the Ghost. Ooh, we almost got that other Ghost up there, too. Yeah, Disruptors are fucking good, dude. This is why I love going Disruptors. Tries to get a flank off, but doesn't really work when you have Disruptors to zone. Actually did pick off a couple of them. Pretty nicely done. But Bunny is really reeling at this point. Forced to pull the SCVs off. It doesn't really have any units here to defend this. Get some nice EMPs off, but it really doesn't matter. He's got nothing left. 3-3 versus 2-2 as well. All of the SCVs getting tanked down. There is only 46 supply left. Bunny, you gotta get out of this game, mate. You got no units. He thinks he can, though. He's got one worker and a dream. He's picking off Disruptors. As Lone Zealot is killing off all the reinforcements. There we go. GG. Did I miss a Disruptor Shop? RIP. Deer takes the first game in the best of seven. What's our second map? Okay. Is this last Korean sign a kind of, no, it's just he didn't switch his keyboard over, so that symbol is where the G key is. But you can also use that to mean ha-ha, because that is the H sound in Korean. But it was, Bunny's not like that, so. I'd imagine it was just the typo. Go, go, go. We doing it. All right. Over on the bottom right hand side, it's Bunny. And on the top left side, it's Deer. It's a proxy T-Rex. And it's no gas either. So he's not even trying to fake that it's a normal proxy. But Deer will be scouting at the normal time. So he will be fully aware of what is happening to him right now. I'm really kind of, okay, there's the gas, I was gonna say. Like, you don't just do proxy T-Rex and expect to win. Like, you're doing some sort of follow-up afterwards. I was getting kind of confused for a second. But yeah, Deer should be fully aware of what it is at this point, and the response out of Protoss is to go Zealot, Core, Pylon at the top. You can get your second gas as well if you want to. Scout around with the probe with it. Use this probe to scout around too. He's not chronoing the Zealot. There we go. Thank you. So chrono the Zealot out, and then chip away at these SCVs as we go. Bunny going and doing a conservative version of this build, not trying to YOLO up on the high ground, because again, he's only doing two racks, so he's not actually trying to end the game with this. He's just trying to put Deer in an extremely awkward position that he can then go ahead and, what you call it, snowball it. Oh, he gets the SCV, nicely done. Should be able to deny this quite simply, though. I don't know what I'm doing with my score here. Don't look at the score, it's not true. Stalker will be coming out, losing a couple more probes than he really needs to, but it's not really that big of a deal. There we go. We did the score. We did it, boys. Okay, shield battery's up. Does want to try and kill off those SCVs, though. I don't think he's going to be able to. So that's actually quite annoying. Now that the bunker gets up, he can't just deny this and go ahead and expand. So that actually makes it very awkward. Oh, if he can get in, block it. Nice. Okay, so he sees the factory, he'll be able to block this a little bit. If he wants, he can even put a pylon here, so that way it's he can run a unit past if he wanted to, but not going to. Yeah, this is just annoying. As a Protoss player, you kind of just have to sit back now and just slow take your expansion. You'll go up to Robo so that you can eventually bust out. But Bunny is going to be going into Cyclones back at home, so any attempted like Warp Prism counterattack and stuff like that should be getting shut down. But now you have to get an Immortal. you have to go into extra gateways when you could just be like, if he just was able to target down the SCVs from getting that bunker up, then he doesn't have to get any of this extra stuff, and he just expands like totally fine, and there's no issue with anything. Meanwhile, Bunny is able to go up into whatever the hell he wants. CC, extra barracks, starport even. But now that the Immortal is out, he is free to kill this off. And he'll be taking his expansion. So yeah, Deer's going to try and go and do a counter push, see what kind of damage he can do while expanding behind it. The Cyclone and the tank should make it so that that's not really possible. He'll try to maybe lift the Immortal and some units onto the tank if he wants, if he really wants to yellow it. But the Cyclone should really shut that down. It's not really going to allow him to do that, I don't think. The Viking as well. It should. Keyword should. There's still some potential. The micro is good, but it's likely, as we can see, it is not. So nothing happening. He will be able to kind of deny this orbital from landing for just a tiny little bit. The Viking will have to shoo away the warp prism, and he'll have to kind of slow push this down his own ramp to get here, but the damage was done, and it's a slight edge for Bunny. Yeah, be careful with that warp prism. Ooh, that was close. He YOLO'd the Viking onto it. Ooh, and he actually gets it. Nice. Good call. Once again, killing that prism relieves so much pressure, but I mean, lift that up so you don't get it getting hit by the Immortal. Or repair it. That's fine too, I guess.
Whoa.
We're good. We good. Colossus transition, out of Deer. Totally normal response, having to get a robo so fast, might as well use it. Colossus is the safest option. You could go Disruptors as well if you want. If you didn't lose the Prism, you could even go into Disruptor Drop, which would be sick. But Colossus is the safe choice. Bunny is just going to go ahead and switch on into the normal 3 racks stim play. Going into mech at this point would be super weird. There's our extra gates. Is it always stupid to try and push Prism into main when they have a Cyclone? Yeah. It's very, very risky. You have to be very far ahead. Like, if they do a very committed proxy, and then you shut it down real hard, and then, like, the only thing they have left is, like, a Cyclone, you can YOLO on top of it and just kill it. If it's a map that kind of caters to that, too, like a very easy spot to elevator stuff into the main, then it's okay to do it, but... this wasn't the situation for it. So Deer's gonna go ahead and try and do what looks like he's actually just doing a 2-base Colossus all in. He's got 6 gates, he's cut all the gas. He's got a probe that could take a 3rd base, but he's gonna be warping in at this pylon over here. He's got 2 Colossus, and Bunny is completely unaware of this, almost catches him in the middle of the map and gets caught out with some force fields, but does lift off and get back to safety behind his semi-wall. Some hallucinated Archons going to try and tank up some of this damage, and they will do so. SCV is going to get pulled off, and now the wall is actually hurting Bunny. Finally lifts down those depots, but... Oh man, what a strong push out of Deer here. A bit random, kind of an unexpected attack, but it's doing quite well. 19 SCVs get killed off, got to take down that tank, and then he's got free reign of the natural now. That's actually sick. What a nice play. Scan only just now going down onto the natural, seeing that, yes, it is a gasless 6 gate. Bunny's been duped. I feel like I'm looking at, like, some 2012 build right here, dude. Like, this is legit Squirtle, level of, you know, 2010 or 2012 two-base Colossus attack. Nice War Prism Micro juggling to dodge the Marauder shots there. None of those Marauder shots are actually connecting. Viking's going to be able to push off this Warp Prism, but it doesn't matter. Because he's dead. He dead. That was a really nice reaction. I like that a lot, actually. It was really, really crisp. Really, really crisp. What's our next map? Nightshade. The first Nightshade we'll be getting tonight. I didn't update the sub goal. Shoot. Whoops. Sorry. Hey, man. Running a tournament and casting it, setting up all the lobbies, doing all this shit. Hey, man. It's hard work, okay? Okay? Give me a break, man. Give me a break. You want me to sell out? You want me to change my sellout? Okay, I'll do it. How many subs we got now? 47. Holy shit. Nice. Good job. All right. Because of you, Borsti, we're now switching back to this screen. So that way we can properly change this. 47 out of 50. Whoops. There we go. You happy now, Borsti? Have your needs been satisfied? Alright, anyway. Poor V-Deck. Alright, top left. Got caught off guard after doing a proxy T-Rex. It is Bunny. Defending the proxy T-Rex and catching the other opponent off guard. It is Deer. Coolio. Thank you all for watching. I hope you're enjoying the tournament. I know there's other stuff going on right now, so I'm glad that you're sticking here. If you are so interested in obtaining the replays of this tournament, then you can go ahead and smash down that !GKI in the chat, or the !Patreon in the chat, and find a link to my Patreon. And any amount of money sent to that page will be allowing you to download the replays of this tournament and all the previous ones and all the future ones, provided that you stay subscribed. And not only that, but all that money gets put towards more tournaments. So it's a self-fulfilling prophecy. You want replays, so you pay money for replays, and then that money gets put towards more tournaments that are providing more replays for you to then continuously download. It's amazing. It's actually just a completely broken system. I don't know how it's been not figured out at this point, but I don't know. Capitalism will eventually find a way. But there you go. If you want some replays, go ahead. Do it. If not, then you can just chill on the VODs on my YouTube channel about a day or two later. But the replays, you get them right after. Well, look at that. We got a Stargate coming out from Deer now. He's got 5 probes on his gas because he's waiting to transfer them down to the natural. He doesn't want to get any caught off by the whatever you call it. !! Sellout. We'll give you the YouTube link. But Bunny is actually going for a 3-rax. And this is a bit of a different build. You don't normally see 3-rax. You do not normally see 3-rax coming out of Terrans these days. It's a bit gimmicky, it's a bit risky, because if the other player is just going for a build that just completely straight up defends it, playing very defensively, then it's useless. It puts you pretty far behind. But versus Stargate, it could actually be pretty decent. You get a lot of units out very quickly, and the finicky Stargate units don't always have enough brunt damage to be able to defend what your opponent's throwing at you. You gotta sometimes have to rely on lucky stasis wards to really defend properly and buy time to get enough units out. And Bunny will now be seeing the Stargate, and so he'll know what kind of position he has and the potential that his build allows. Me, on the other hand, I go Disruptor Drop a lot, so seeing three racks is basically like a free win for me. So, I would love to see this as a Protoss player. And yeah, very fast Nexus coming out of Deer, so this is exactly what this type of build is meant to deny, and we'll see if Bunny can pull that off. Because we all do know that Protoss is Protoss, so sometimes the way things are supposed to work, or the way things you think are supposed to work out, don't actually work out. And then you end up sad. He's gonna try to YOLO in here, focus down some of these Marines before any stim or anything is completed. Gets a couple Marines, but loses all three Adepts. And a whole bunch of Oracle hole damage. If I had a not worth button, I would throw it up right now. But I do not have one of those. Okay, there's the chart, or the Twilight and the Forge follow-up. Blink or Charge, I'm not sure exactly what it'll be. It could really be either, but if he scouts the fact that it is three racks, which he only barely did not, but he might be able to assume it based off of that. I think he's going to go Blink. Going Charge versus three racks is kind of a waste. It doesn't really do you anything. Yeah, plus one Blink. It has to be Blink. Ayo, it's like I play this game. Stim bio is going to come around to the side. It doesn't have any Marauders with it, though, so that's actually not really going to do him too good. It seems like Deer is fully aware of this. Gets the Stasis Ward down. Doesn't want to commit, though. Sees the shield batteries being morphed in. Oh, now he's going to commit. Some units going into the natural tube, trying to focus down some of the probes. Gets a couple. Oh, he tried to go for the Oracle. Didn't quite get it. So it looks like Deer holds. I mean, I was kind of confused by the attack, to be honest with you. Like, usually there's like a couple Marauders with that push as well to like really power through some of the gateway units. But I don't know. It didn't happen. They weren't there. I'm not really quite sure what happened, to be honest with you. Now the Marauders are here. Third base being made on location. There's not really much of for Deer to really contest that, so totally fine. Spreading out as much vision as possible, knowing that the two medevac drop could potentially be coming out now, but Bunny is just gonna walk it down mid, not really caring about trying to go for the sides, knowing that the opponent did open Stargate, so it's likely undefended, or is defended. And so the spot that is completely undefended is right exactly where Bunny goes, but that is quite a lot of stalkers, and with shield batteries to help, I don't think that this is going to be doing much of anything as Bunny gets forced back. Is he going to be able to chase it with the Phoenix and the Blink Stalkers even? Get it! Robo Bay and Charge coming on up. Bunny's definitely hurting a little bit after that opening. Didn't exactly go to his plan. He's really got to get a scout off on this Robotech as well, because a lot of times you will see players go into just straight Blink Charge with Templar support after going Stargate, but seeing the fact that it was Blink first instead of Charge should kind of lead Bunny to believe that it will be a Robo Colossus transition, and he is getting a second Starport, preparing for that. Finds a couple Stalkers out in the middle, stims and kills a couple. Deer's doing a really good job of getting vision all over the map, sending out different pylons, different random probes and units. Doing a really good job of that. Sees a whole lot of his side of the map. He's really active. And of course, again, the one spot that he doesn't have vision is where Bunny fucking goes. And he's gonna get a cancel on the fourth base. Nice moves right there. Scans the other fourth to make sure he sees where the other units are as well. Nicely done by Bunny. We should get Bunny signed up to be a kicker on a fucking NFL team, dude, because he is really good at kicking these field goals right through Deer's vision. A couple Zealots are going to try and do a little counterattack, but Bunny is somehow prepared for it. Puts the units right towards it. So while Bunny did kind of start off this game a little bit on the back foot, those last couple moves that we just saw in those last 30 seconds actually kind of put him on a quite good spot. He's got solid worker count. His upgrades are kind of coming along. He only has one eBay, it looks like. Oh no, he's got... Yeah, only one eBay. So that will be a bit rough as we get going further into the game. Deer will really start to kind of pull ahead in the upgrade lead if there's no other eBay going down. Blinks on up, snipes down some of those marauders, since there's only a small part of Deer or Bunny's army there. But Bunny again, he's feeling fine. I think he's feeling pretty okay with this situation. There's been worse spots as a Terran player that you can be in. He's got his double starport reactor going, making a bunch of Vikings. He could eventually tech switch into Liberators if he so desires. Especially considering that Deer is going for Le Disruptors once more. However, the Ghost Academy is coming out for Bunny again, so it seems like he's more comfortable on that that route. I really like that Deer's going for this Disruptor switch. This validates my entire late-game PvT style. Like, I know it's really good and I find success with it, but like, I don't see as many Protosses doing it. A lot of them really do prefer the Templar Storm. So to see at least one of the higher level Protosses do it gives me some satisfaction, some reassurance. A lot of Zealots coming in different places. We got a huge big warp into the main, dropped a few into the natural, and some are trying to run by over to the fourth or third. Those ones are gonna get cleaned up easily. The Warp Prism actually gets sniped before the warping can complete. So Bunny actually shuts that down entirely. Big reversal compared to that first game when the Warp Prism absolutely shred him a new one. Killed off like 30 SCVs or something like that. Now we're seeing the Storm transition, so Deer realizing that he doesn't have the same lead that he does in the Triton game to really force the issue and push into Bunny's position. Gonna complete the Storm, Colossus, Disruptor, Storm, Splash Damage, Trifecta. But once again, Bunny seems to be finding the openings where Deer's army and Vision are not. So he's gonna go ahead and stim into the natural as Deer tries to take out this Planetarian up in the top. He'll be able to do that. But Bunny is getting into the heart of some of the juicy insides of the Protoss. Gonna kill off the third base, could even go for the Forges and other tech over here. He already got one. But there's already Zealots and DTs going into the natural. I guess there's a Warp Prism somewhere or something. I don't know. Maybe from down here they came. So Bunny is going to be losing just as much as Deer here. There is always going to be the recall available. Actually, the DTs are a great call here. He's going to force all the orbitals to lift. And now all these scans are going to have to get used on the DTs. Whoa, what is this? That was awkward. Two Raptors go down for free. Deer deciding to walk it back instead of recalling. Can't get up that main base. And Bunny is not quite positioned at the front. Should be really guarding this choke point up at the ramp here. Gonna make it really awkward for Deer to get up into this base. I feel like maybe he should have recalled like half his army so that he could do a flank while trying to walk up the ramp here, because it's gonna be really difficult for him now. Even though his army is much larger and he does have Colossus range to poke away, Vikings will be able to get pick off at them too, and the Stalkers aren't all fully in position. Oh, that Disruptor hit! Actually, pretty nice micro. Nice micro again. So again, we can see how difficult it is for Deer to push up into this base, and the recall was available. He definitely could have gone for a flank like that. I think that could have been a good move. still obviously a very hard move to make in that decision or in that situation, because if you recall the right units in the improper way, then they can very easily snipe down some important units and you won't be able to use any of them. But takes it patiently, waits for some more warp-ins, and will eventually be able to force these units out. We'll be able to chase it as well. Rip. Deer has like no production because all of his shit is unpowered. Bunny actually did keep all three of his orbitals, which is kind of surprising. So he's got a lot of mule potential here. But the problem is that he doesn't have an army that could reliably deal with whatever Deer has at this current point in time. It's all kind of around in different areas. But he's going to actually get a full surround. The disruptors actually get caught off in the back. That's a huge move right there. Ooh, we're going to lose a bit there. Deer is able to connect with the rest of his units, so that's going to help out. Still extremely, extremely even. These Zealot counters and the DT counters are going to really fuck up Bunny, though. If he doesn't leave anything behind to deal with this, it's going to really mess with him.
Quicker than me, you know?
Ooh, what's up, Ravens TV 2? Thank you for the host. Hope you enjoyed your stream. Welcome to the tourney. We're in the finals of the Gemini Korean Invitational with Deer and Bunny. Deer up 2-0, and we're in a bit of a scrap fest for game number 3. As Deer finds some of Bunny's units caught off guard, Bunny's going to try to maybe go for a flank. Nope, going to YOLO it. Going to go and snipe down one of these bases. But that does leave the rest of his units quite exposed, and those are all going to get picked off. Bunny's really trying to find something here. Can't really find it, though. Amazing analysis. Ask me more in a little bit. Yeah, dude, these DT run-bys are absolutely killing it. Just non-stop. Where does he have detection from? What the heck? He was shooting that with, like, no detection. What the hell? Oh, shoot. I had the wrong score this whole time. My bad. Deer's 2-0, Bunny. And now it's 3-0. XD. Alright. Zen is our next map. Bathroom break called. Totally fine. I need some water. What is this guy? What kind of question is that? Toss good race indeed. Indeed. Not good enough for trap though. Rip. Rip. Feels bad, man. Really did not expect that result, honestly. Wow, you just got super baited in chat there, dude. We're waiting on Bunny's going to the bathroom real quick. No, I'm not, Vaga. I'm actually a Taurus, but I don't pay attention to astrology things at all. My name is from the, it's from the constellation, yes, but also the space program, the Gemini program, during the space race in the 60s and 50s. We all ready to go. Money's back. We're rocking. We're on match point. Because it's 3-0 for Deer. But he's got to pull some magic. And Zen is quite a map to do it. I can see a gnarly tank push in my near future. It would be a strong choice. Nope. There we go. Alright, he's down 0-3. He really needs to pull something out of his bum to pull it on back. Give it up for Buddy! And it's Deer. Yeah, I really want to see if Bunny does go for one of these tank pushes, because I feel like this map is so strong for it. This ledge is super huge. Like, the range of a tank, if you put it right here, it's literally one pixel away from the Nexus, but this entire area gets shot at. And then you have this little tiny ramp that you can also siege underneath and put Liberators on top of. So it's like, it's so hard to engage this. Then you have to go all the way around and shit. Then you have these little tiny choke points to attack through as well. I just feel like tank pushes are super strong in this map. I've seen a couple of them on different random ladder streams and stuff like that to be pretty good. Special was doing it. I saw Soul beat Harston with it at one point too. They're good builds. They are good builds. Bunny threw away last game. Did he though? I don't really know if it was a throw. I mean, it was pretty even the whole time. He had a decent... Oh, Proxy Stargate, nice. Like, he had a decent spot. Oh my god, is he really gonna go Widowmine drop again? Bunny, what the fuck? Come on, man. Just tank push him, dude. This map's nuts. Like, I feel like Bunny had a decent edge in one spot when he sniped the fourth base and stuff and killed like the Zealot run bys and stuff. But he never really had such a large advantage that he was very clearly... Oh, nice scout. He was never very clearly like, yes, he is 100% going to win this game. It was extremely even the entire time. The Adept is coming into the natural, going to try and poke away at the SCVs, make it really annoying for Bunny here. But it looks like Deer's also going to commit, because he's got his second Adept coming over here, so he'll be able to chase this Reaper away and actually get the Oracle out. Followed with a Twilight. Interesting. Interesting indeed. Could have just killed Deer's third and just all in. Deer's on tier 1 for 8 to 10 minutes. Where was he going to kill the third? At one point would he do that? Oh, he could have surrounded that. Wasn't paying attention. Because he's going with the Oracle! And doesn't really kill anything with it. Unfortunate. So, good defense by Bunny. Defends the Oracle, the Proxy Oracle. I think he killed the Adept even, too. So, nice defense. Now it's going to be up to Deer to defend the Widowmine drop that'll be coming in eventually. He's going to be going into Blink. Did he get the medivac? Oh, no, he didn't. He just went straight for a Viking, since it was Proxy Oracle. He just wanted to be safer. Kind of surprising Deer's PvT is way better than Traps. Yeah. I feel like Trap maybe just had a not good two games. curious to see how good Deer does in GSL this season, since he usually kind of like flubs around in GSL. Yeah, Deer's PvT was also really good last year. And I think the year before, if I remember correctly. So, he's been good. He's been good for a while. It's just he's very inconsistent with it. Not even the Viking is gonna get the pylon, man. No. Rip. No, Bunny would never want a BlizzCon. He's making cannons and batteries and stuff too. What the heck? What is Deer preparing for here? He's like really certain that there's some huge drop happening right here. Did he like see a pickup on the other side of the map and get duped or something? He's like so sure that there's a drop happening right here. But Bunny's just walking all his stuff over to the third. Deer's only gonna see it right as it's at him. This observer is in a nice spot though, so that's gonna give him a good amount of vision to know exactly when Bunny tries to go over to the natural. And he can respond in kind. Dream would destroy Deer. Dream was actually gonna play in the tournament. But then the BJ Destruction League thing that was happening earlier today, which was the original time, made it so that he wasn't able to, unfortunately. So. I really do want to get Dream in one of these tournaments because he plays very, very well. He's been increasing in skill so fast, especially in the online cups. I feel like he's going to do super well in 2020. I'm so interested to see how good he's going to do. Can he trigger that stasis from the bottom? That would be so interesting if he like walked to the edge and it triggered it. Deer's just playing super safe, dude. He's not taking a single risk here. He's got cannons and batteries everywhere. He's got units and stasis wards all spread out. He's just not letting Bunny do anything to him. Yeah, Dream just got out of the military earlier this year. He's gonna try to stim up into the natural. Kills off an observer, which is nice. But with a Colossus out, yeah, you can't do anything there, Bunny. Leave the premises. Oh, that little choke point's cute. Nice. Oh, there was an attempted Widowmine drop, it looks like. Didn't do shit. How many stasis wards? This is such an interesting usage of this. I guess Deer has played a game or two against Bunny or some other Terran on this map who just did non-stop drop harass on this top hand side, and just he's been scarred for life. He never wants to deal with it ever again. Just defending it as much as humanly possible. So Deer's going into the Disruptor switch once more. He really, really, really likes that style, it seems. Bunny, on the other hand, going for the exact same thing again as well. No Liberators, straight into Ghosts. I really feel like Liberators are so good now. I don't understand why Terrans don't make them. You like my ob skills? Thanks. Sometimes I like to give myself a break and let you guys see what it's like to see it through the player's perspective. I think it's kind of cool. I feel like Liberators are so good. Especially now that you can react to them twice at a time while still getting the upgrade. Like, I saw Inno dick someone on ladder with that. I think he bopped Parting on stream the other day. Going mass Liberator. It was super good. Drop's gonna try and zoom its way up into the main base. There's nothing here to defend it. Drop some Zealots over to the planetary, and that's not done yet, so that's gonna get quite a lot of damage done while still pushing into the natural as well. Jumps up, gets a nice disruptor shot on a lot of these ghosts. Huge Zealot, actually only two Zealots. Healed off the War Prism, so only a few get out. Deer doing a decent amount of damage here, but he does have to back off eventually. Nice force fields up here. Does lose some of the Colossus though. These two Zealots are still not dead though. So 20 SCVs have actually gone down. This one has 6 kills, holy moly. A nice move by Deer. Picking himself a nice economic lead, taking another base in the meantime. Still has so much vision on the map, I love it. Look at all this vision, dude. I love this, excuse me, this type of play. I love players that control the map and find as much vision on it as possible. Oh, huge drop over to this bottom side. I don't think he was expecting to see a base here, but he got it anyway. So he'll be able to kill that. It's a nice play, nice pickoff by Bunny. Needs to make sure to get out of there though. Doesn't want to lose all that. Forcing Deer back onto equal bases with him while taking his fifth base soon. I don't know what these Marines are doing here. Poggers, Stefan. Poggers indeed. Double medevac drop getting pushed on over to the main, but there is still a decent amount of defense here. Just barely misses it with his army, wow. Wow, wow, wow. Holy shit, there's so many disruptors. Dude, Deer, I love you. What the hell? He's gonna try to push in two fronts at once with two different armies with two different types of splash damage. This is kind of tough to do, honestly. Like, goddamn, he's gonna lose all the EMPs, yep. Or all the storms to the EMP. Nice split. Gonna be able to deal with this army quite efficiently, but this army at the bottom has plenty of disruptors. This a supply depot block, though, is really fucking him over. Now all the disruptors are gonna get caught. He's gonna try and fire them all out, see how many he can get. Nice shot there. But yeah, that was a bit of a flub, and that is why that's exactly what I said. That's a difficult thing to control, having not only two oh my god, it's a massive warp-in. Not only having two separate control groups of different armies, but having two different types of spellcasting splash damage made that really awkward to control. And so he kind of flubbed it, lost a lot of his key units. Did get a nice warp-in in the main, but he did lose them all to a scan, an EMP, and a turret. So that honestly did not go very well for our neighborhood friend Deer. Neighborhood. English is hard sometimes, guys, I'll tell you. Talk for 4 hours straight and you're gonna say some stupid shit. I'm honestly amazed at the amount of things that I don't manage to fuck up when I'm teaching kids nonstop for 4 hours a day. 5 hours a day. I almost dropped a fuck in front of him the other day. I was real close to it. I'm amazed I haven't done it yet, to be honest with you. I did drop an ass one time accidentally. Said like big ass or like nice ass, like to like describe like how big something, like, oh, this is going wrong. alright, I'm not gonna bother explaining my way out of that one. Never mind. No problem. No problem. Not gonna bother with that one. Give me a Monka TOS on the chat, boys. Monka TOS. Monka TOS. Not in front of the children, no. Disruptor shots getting some pretty good shots off, but EMPs over all the army makes it so that deer can't quite fully engage into here. And he's going to be losing a decent amount of his gateway. Ooh, nice little pickup micro there. Bunny is still consistently dodging these shots pretty well, actually. There's only four Ruptors. Yikes. I feel like Deer just finally realized that he has like 20 units up in his main. Maybe he was defending a drop and I didn't notice it. He's doing an interesting job of spreading out his army, so it's not usually all in one clump. He's always got these really big counterattack things going on, which is kind of interesting. You don't normally see this get with Protoss as much. Why doesn't he make Liberators? Yeah, I don't know, man. I really don't know. Liberators are so strong. Especially on this map, like, it's very easy to just put, like, two lib zones right here. You can really force it down the middle with some lib zones. It's kind of a choky map. I feel like Liberators would be very strong on this map, but he does not want to make them. For whatever reason. I guess he lost his DT shrine. He's rebuilding it, right? Yeah, I was gonna say, is he making another dark shrine? It's like, swore I saw some DTs earlier. Ooh, if he's looking, okay. Could have gotten some pretty big ruptor shots there, but ooh, gets a couple ghosts, which is actually not bad. But the micro is on point, but the, oh no, he wasn't paying attention and repairing his planetary, so that's gonna be a bit of a loss. He's gonna have to lift up one of these orbital commands and put it there. Or just remake a CC, that works too, I guess. So that way he can make another orbital. Ooh, nice split. The ghost. This game is nuts, by the way. I feel like we're gonna get every base taken soon enough. There's only a few left. Level 3 air upgrades without air. Yeah. That's true. Oh shit. Was it anything? Sorry. My, like, earbud fell out. He's pulling probes to attack. Okay, this is an interesting choice. He really wants to save this base up here, it seems like. Not sure if that was worth the 16 probe sacrifice, though. Kind of an interesting choice there. Looks like Deer's starting to get a little bit sloppy once this game is starting to get kind of chaotic. Another attack going down here, nice storm, gonna be able to defend off some of this. Another big storm there, but it still needs a warp in. Gonna blink on top of the units up here. We'll be able to kill off some of them, but Deer does defend in both locations. And Bunny is kind of starting to shave off a bit of his army supply. Oh, we could even catch these. Oh, he wasn't paying attention. Bunny is really starting to shave off some of his army supply, trying to get some of this damage done, whereas Deer isn't losing as much of his army. So Bunny definitely still has to be very careful in how he takes these fights. Ooh, it even finally gets jumped on over here. It loses all these medevacs and bio units. I really feel like having some liberators, man. Like, get some liberators that... Ooh, nice disruptor shots on all those SCVs. Beautifully done. Yeah, Bunny's just getting picked apart at this point right now, man. Like, he really needs just, like, some liberators to just hunker down behind. He needs some sort of staging point that he could just sit behind that won't have any damage be taken. And without having any liberators to give him that thing to hunker down under, He's just getting picked apart. He has no safe space. He's getting triggered. I like how there's like five sensor towers all covering about the same area. Oh, nice disruptor shots. I combined shots and hits there. Nicely done. Oh man, Bunny's just getting absolutely torn apart, dude. He has no idea where to go. There's units on all sides. Disruptors everywhere. How many disruptors are on the field right now? Six. Thought there were more. Whoop. Okay. Still some good splits, but when you're down 100 supply with no bases, it's gonna be a bit tough, I'd say. This is Bunny's last ditch effort. A lot of zealots gonna go ahead and massacre what's left of Bunny's SCV line. Some more disruptor shots. Oh, big poggers shot right there. One marine on that one, but I mean, it doesn't matter, dude. He's got absolutely nothing left. Stimming in to try and snipe some of those disruptors. Blinks over to intercept them, and all of a sudden, Bunny, he's got nothing left. And Deer, he's gonna full sweep at a 4-0 finals to become the first Protoss champion of a GKI. Very well done for him. Excellent play. Yeah, Deer did play all three races as well. Look at that. Look at that. Bada bing, bada boom. 2-0'd SOS. He didn't lose a single fucking map, dude. Holy shit, Deer. Going absolute madman right now. Holy moly. Dude, like, never plays in online tournaments, so now he's coming over here and just absolutely dick-rolling everybody in all three matchups as well. Holy jeebus. Very well done. Wowzers, wowzers, wowzers. All right. So, there we have it. 4 hours on the clock. I was honestly expecting it to be a little longer, but I guess the couple of sweeps did... actually, it was a lot of sweeps. Holy shit. It's only two matches were not a sweep. That's incredible. What the hell? What are the chances of that, man? Very interesting. They're going ham in chat. They're talking some stuff. I don't know. Anyway, thank you all for watching. Much appreciated. I hope you guys enjoyed the tournament. Deer was our winner. Thanks again for anyone that did support the Patreon as well. If you do !GKI or Patreon in the chat, you'll be able to see a link to the Patreon where the funds for this tournament and all the other tournaments were found. Any dollar amount that goes above 100 per month will get put towards another tournament to get funded. I've got enough money for one more at this point, and we'll see how much we're still kicking in afterwards. What was I gonna say? Oh yeah, if you want the replays. If you do support the tournament, then you also get replays for that tournament. I'll have them up in just a little bit. So I'll go through them, make sure that everyone emailed them to me and whatnot. and I'll send those out. Big thank you again to all the Patreons in the chat and the world. Let me list them off. Da, 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 da. How do I even look at that? Patrons. What's the easiest way to do this? I swear, I need to make an actual list of my patrons. View all current patrons. Here we go. Is there a way to make it so you don't see what they're... how much they're paying? That'd be great. And I can just list them off. Diesel Max Power, Too Easy to Anyone, Benjamin Terracini, Lanzer, Thomas Halley Simons, Creighton Olsen the God, Daniel White, Ravi Parikh, Ravi Cheech Chong, Matthew Bakke, Jim Tony, oh rip. Yelbana, Matt 500, Steve Ramos, Clockwork, Sphinx, Victor Colteran, and Daniel Killa. Thank you all for being a patron. Thank you all for watching. It's much appreciated as always. I'm gonna cut the stream. We've been going for a while now. I'm not gonna play much afterwards. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys enjoyed it, then be sure to follow and whatnot. Usually I do streaming of just normal Protoss gameplay. So if you're into that, I do Korean ladder over here in Korea. GM ladder. So if you're interested, I try to help out as much as I can, give out an intelligent, insightful commentary. Or I'm just getting really fucking mad. I'm like a mini Artosis basically. I get salty. So if that's also your enjoyment, then please you can tune into that as well. Thank you again for watching, everybody. I'm going to go ahead and make sure these players get paid. I am going to wrap up all the replays. And we are going to find somebody to raid up. Let's see. Who is live? Who is here? Ooh, Wardy's doing the China Team Championship. Another tournament that makes it very difficult to schedule my own. Yeah, we can kick that off. It's got a ZVZ right now, so those of you who are interested in that know we've been having a bit of a sparsity. There's been a bit of a drought this year of ZVZs, I know. So if you guys are really interested, I think we can go throw it on over here. I think you guys would really like that. But for real, give him a hello, tell him that he's awesome or something. I don't know. Thank you all for watching again, much appreciated, and I will see you all in the future at some point in time. Rip on, later, peace.